जागे दिल के जलाओ के ईद का दिन है तराने चूम के गाओ के ईद का दिन है चिरागे दिल के जलाओ के ईद का दिन है से जाओ के ईद का दिन है खुशी की बस्म से जाओ के ईद का दिन है चिरागे दिल के जलाओ के ईद का दिन है सजने प्याज झुकाओ के ईद का दिन है चिरागे दिल के जलाओ के ईद का दिन है
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I will not take up much of your time. But as your Imam and spiritual leader of Masjid Abidin, allow me on behalf of myself and on behalf of my family to extend to each and every one of you, inshaAllah, Eid Mubarak, Eid Sa'eed, Kullu Amin wa Antum Bi Khair. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and bless your family members and reward you immensely for all the ibadat and the ta'at that you have engaged in. I take this moment to humbly appeal to all of you to hold hands with us here at Masjid Abidin as we strive and struggle to build a community that is based on taqwa Allah Azza wa Jal. I appeal to your hearts to hold our hands as we work for our youth. Our vision here at Masjid Abidin is to transform the lives of our youth and our community through education and through tazkiyah and services for community and through transformation through akhlaq. The madrasa here at Masjid Abidin is the light of our community, and as such we appeal to you to continuously donate and to give as we work hard and as we work diligently to construct the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We want to thank all of you as well, joined with the President, in thanking all of our brothers and our sisters who have contributed towards, inshallah, our community and contributed towards the building of Masjid Abidin. Whatever little that you have given, may Allah reward you and make this good act be in your mizan and hasanat on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Imam and the chairman of the steering committee who has taken on this responsibility of seeing this project into the final phase and into completion. My beloved brothers and sisters, he's no stranger to any of us, Imam Samir Sattar.
Alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nusallim ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in, amma ba'du. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. La ilaha illallah. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Walillahil hamd. Eid Mubarak, Eid Sa'eed, Kullu Amin wa Antum Bi Khair. His Eminence Fadilat al-Sheikh Qari Fahmi Abdul Qawi, His Eminence Sheikh Imam Qari Ibrahim Awad, Sheikh Safraz Bakas, Imam Masjid Abidin, Brother President Haj Abdulaziz Madin, members of the Executive Board and Trustee Board of Masjid Abidin, sisters, brothers, children, I greet you all this morning with a salutation of peace. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. Eid Mubarak, Eid greetings to each and every one of you. I pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He will bless all of us here this morning as we are gathered to celebrate the conclusion of Ramadan al-Mubarak, a month of fasting, a month of patience. And we are honored and we are blessed to witness not just the Eid-ul-Fitr, but because of the fact we are allowed to witness the completion of a month of mercy, a month of forgiveness, and a month of freedom from the hellfire. Allahu Akbar. Last year, we were gathered here on the same street at this historical gathering at the corner of 127th Street and Liberty Avenue, in which during that same time we stood in front of you and we tried yet to convince you, my brothers and sisters in Turin, that it was quite necessary, that is why, and it is important for us to continue to support Masjid Abedin building project. And while I realize that for so many of you, you are very frustrated at this moment, to see yet another year has passed without the completion of this building. The end is near. The real end, this journey, will soon come to an end. We are closer now than ever. With the approval of the permit to build or to continue up with the third floor of the structure 1 week prior to the commence of Ramadan and Mubarak, now we can continue the construction. This project has finally, after much time, entered into its final stage. From the moment I was asked, from the moment I was requested to join the steering committee and to assume the leadership of rebuilding this historic structure that was humbly started 40 years ago, I knew that it was not simple. It was not simple, and it was not the building of a structure or a building. These times are too important and too crucial for us to simply build a masjid and think that all our problems will be solved. From the day one, the steering committee has understood the core principles that are necessary to preserve and to protect Islam in this area for the generations to come. And I want every one of you to understand this very clearly, my brothers and sisters, that while many are coming to Islam on a daily basis, many are leaving Islam. And perhaps as the statistics has recorded at this moment, that more than 25% of our youths are leaving the fold of Islam. And our community is not safe from this. We are part of this. This virus has also hit us. With this, we need to understand that our role and responsibility is not to establish a building, but it is to build a community of Masjid Al-Awli. This building project, it's much more than construction and expansion. Masjid Al-Awli will soon be the shining star in Queens and in New York City. I appeal to every one of you here today, be part of this historic journey. This journey of coming closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we make our journey, we want each and every one of you to understand it is to enrich this community with Islamic knowledge of the deen and to move also to strengthen the ability to deal with the hard issues. There are answers to every problem, but we simply have to seek them out. This project represents this community moving forward, my brothers and sisters. It represents a transmission from Masjid Al-Awli to a full and complete Islamic center, where Masjid Al-Awli will not be just a component that will serve as a masjid, but beyond this. This idea It is not a radical one. In fact, many communities around the United States offer a model where their center is so much more than just a masjid. It is the natural next step for our progress and growth of Masjid Al-Amini. Ma'ashir al-Hadirin, honorable audience here today, this morning. I want each and every one of you to understand that Richmond Hill, it is the hub. It is the stop for every immigrant that comes into this country. Everyone begins their journey from Richmond Hill, and they eventually move on to other cities or states. This community is very important to all of us. This community has much more, it has much potential that could be offered here. And each and every one of us need to understand this. I can't say for certain, although one of our trustees has promised that next year we'll be playing in the new structure. I cannot promise you that this morning. You are the ones who have to make that determination here. Is it that you want to stay on the street next year in Eid-ul-Fitr? Is this what you choose? Is this your choice? Or are we going to finish and we're going to complete the structure? The decision lies within you here this morning. Brothers and sisters, I ask of you, Alhamdulillah, Summa Alhamdulillah, you have donated, those who are here, but many of us here this morning are first timers, and I welcome each and every one of you. Welcome to Masjid Abidi. Here is your home. Special welcome to you. Special welcome to those who came to Masjid Abidi for the first time during the month of Ramadan. Welcome again. This structure, we need at least close to $2 million more for the completion of this project. During the month of Ramadan, we have gone beyond. We have gone to many new communities, and we stood at the doors of mosques and centers, and we have collected dollars and notes and pledges. If all our pledges are to be received in a timely manner within a week or two, we can safely say that we probably would have approximately $1.2 million. We need $200,000 here this morning before we can start engaging the construction committee. In order for us to engage the general contractor next week to make plans for us to continue the structure, we need to collect here this morning at least $200,000.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Wallahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Wa lillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar kabira. Walhamdulillahi kathira. Wa subhanallahi bukratan wa asila. La ilaha illallah. ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون الحمد لله الذي سهل لعباده طريق العباد ويسر واجعل لهم عيدا يعود عليهم بعد إكمال صيامهم ويتكرر وواصل له مواصيل الخيرات ليوفيهم أجورهم ويزيدهم من فضله الذي لا يحصى فيما إن قضى شهر الصيام إلا وأعقبه بأشهر الحج إلى بيته المطهر. أحمده يا الله وهو أحق أن يحمد ويشكر، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة يأمن من قالها وعمل بمقتضاها يوم الفزع الأكبر. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صاحب المقام المحمود والكوثر صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأزواجه ومن اتبعه بالإحسان إلى يوم الدين. قال تعالى في كتابه المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل بفضل الله وبرحمته وبذلك فليفرحوا هو خير مما يجمعون. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم للصائم فرحتان، فرحة عند فطره وفرحة عند لقاء ربه. All praises are due to Allah. We praise Him and we exalt the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We beseech His help and His aid, and we beseech His assistance. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He shows us righteousness as righteousness and give us the ability, the strength and the iman and the faith to embrace righteousness. We praise Allah in the manner He deserves to be praised. He is the first and He is the last. He is the giver of life and He, Allah, is the taker of life. We acknowledge His lordship over us and we submit to the will and the irada of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we testify that there is no deity deserves to be worshipped but Allah. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the seal of our prophets, and that he has strived and struggled to raise the banner of La ilaha illallah to the entire humankind. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. Beloved gathering brothers and sisters in Islam, indeed the day of Eid is a day that is described as the day of Sharif. It is an honorable day for all of us and our family members. It's a day in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has venerated for us. A day in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made a festive time for the people of ta'ah, for the people of obedience to Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a festive time for those people who have submitted their hearts to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and abstained from the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited them to engage in. A festive time for those who have abstained from food and drink and marital relationship for a period of time for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is definitely a festive time for those people who have engaged the nights and the days in ibadah of their prayers, my brothers and sisters in Islam. It is a festive time for those people who displayed generosity in this blessed month or in the blessed month of Ramadan. My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, it is a time in which the believers, the mu'minun, The believers, they show this joy and this happiness because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted us the tawfiq and the hidayah and the strength and the afiyah to fulfill our religious obligation. My brothers and sisters, therefore, I say to all of you, be merryful. It is your right on this day to display your joy. This is because we reap on this day the harvest, subhanAllah, of the seed that we have planted. We reap the crops of the seed that we have planted. That seed that we have planted in the month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showers His mercy and His blessings upon us. Listen, my beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, what our Prophet, our teacher, our master, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what he informs us about. He says, لِصَّائِمُ فَرْحَتَان. A person that fasted in the month of Ramadan, they have two joyous moments. You have engaged in fasting, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying to us that there are two joyous moments, two festive moments for a fasting person. One, at the conclusion of the month of Ramadan, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us basically the results of our actions, and He gives us the fruits, the seed that we have planted. And then He says, subhanAllah, يَوْمَ لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ. The day when we will stand in front of our Lord, when we will reach our Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that is a moment of farh. That is a moment of joy, because Allah will address us with honor. Allah will address us with dignity and put our names to be among the names of the people to enter into a special door that is called Ar-Rayyan. It is, my brothers and sisters in Islam, a joyous moment for us. Why? Because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam informs us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to the people of Jannah, Ya Ahlul Jannah, Ya Ahlul Jannah, O people of paradise, فَيَقُولُ لَبَّيْكَ رَبَّنَا وَسَعْدَيْكَ وَالْخَيْرُ كُلُّهُ فِي يَدَيْكَ. The people of paradise will say, we answer your call, O Allah, for indeed every good is in your hands. And Allah will ask the believers on that particular day, are you pleased with what Allah has prepared for you? And they say, subhanAllah, yes, we are pleased. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to them, I increase for you something that is better than that. And what is that? That we will not on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, as the people of paradise, as the people of devotion, when we were on the face of this earth, Allah says, La أَسْخَطُ عَلَيْكُمْ. I will not display any anger upon you on this day, but rather I will display my love for you. That is one reason why we should show joy and be merryful, my beloved brothers and sisters in Islam. The important lesson that we learn from this is, number one, that we must always be grateful for what Allah has done for us. The transformation in the month of Ramadan. Always display gratitude. This is the best attitude that each and every one of us can adopt. My brothers and sisters in Islam, remember that you start to live when you commit your life to a cause higher than yourself. We have an obligation to learn to depend on the divine power for the fulfillment of a higher cause. I ask you, what is your higher cause? What is it that Allah wants of you as a individual, as a believer? Allah wants of you as a believer and as an individual to connect your hearts to Him and to serve humanity. You have to take up that mantleship of serving Allah and serving Subhanallah, the community in which you live in. Your mission should not be services to yourself, but rather to your community. Your mission should not be, Subhanallah, the servitude to yourself, but rather to the poor and the needy in our community. Your mission should not be servitude to yourself, but rather the distressed in our community. Your mission, as believing men and women, as taught to us by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is not to serve yourself, but rather to serve the oppressed and the voiceless and the abused. My brothers and sisters in Islam, I say to all of you, despite you drive, for example, a BMW or a simple car, at the end of the day, what happens, both of those cars, Subhanallah, will carry you to that same destination. Whether, Subhanallah, you use a Samsung phone or an iPhone X, for example, it both assists you to talk, you're able to communicate the same. My brothers and sisters in Islam, despite you flying in first class or you fly in an economy class, for example, it will take you the same destination. What is my point? The point is that it is amazing that we see many people work so hard to raise the standard of their living rather than raising the standard of their life. Sometimes we have to understand that happiness in this life, it is not about raising the standard of our living, but rather, Subhanallah, the standard of our lives. Drive whatever you want. Wear whatever you want. Transport from point A to point B for whatever means of transportation. But do not, at no time, allow, Subhanallah, your pursuit to a higher material living be the reason for you to forget about the principle that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala has embedded in your hearts. Live with principles. Live with code and ethics, and Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will raise you to a higher plane and a higher level. My brothers and my sisters in Islam, you know, I came across something quite amazing, and I want to share this with all of you. We can learn so much from the creation of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And while reading this particular article, was telling us about this amazing creation of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, and that is the eagle. Most of us knows the bird, the eagle, for example. It is that very strong bird that stands out, Subhanallah. And if we study this bird and we learn from this bird, we will learn so much principles in our life, especially our youngsters that are here. That if you look at the eagle, for example, you will see, my brothers and sisters, that Subhanallah, that the eagle flies alone at a very high altitude, not with the sparrows, not with the geese, but rather in a very high altitude. And as such, Subhanallah, we have to understand, if we want to attain Allah's pleasure, that we must raise ourselves above those that are below us, inshallah. And do not allow in any way, Subhanallah, that distraction from raising to that high pinnacle. Be that individual. I say to our youngsters, I say to our community, that if you want to build a strong society, you have to raise above, Subhanallah, those thoughts, and raise above those negativity, and be like that eagle that flies alone, Subhanallah. My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, this is a lesson that we can learn, that if we want to achieve, for example, spirituality, we have to aim high. That is why, Subhanallah, many of the ulama or scholars, we talk about, if you have a dream, Subhanallah, something that, Subhanallah, that will take you to the stars. Do not dream below there, but have high expectation and work towards them, inshallah. And this is what we see to our youngsters and also to our congregation. My brothers and elders, I also say to you that the eagle has an excellent vision and concentration. to catch the Ibreen. And one of the things we learn from this is that we must always be focused on the important thing. There is Muhim and there is Al-Aham. And many of times we focus on the less important things in life and we forget the most important thing in life. And the most important thing in life as believers is servitude to Allah and servitude to humanity. Allah tells us in the glorious Quran that He has made mankind as a Khalifa on the face of this earth. He has made us a vicegerent on the face of this earth. Our duty is to build and construct and not to demolish. Today in the world in which we live in, we see so much chaos, subhanAllah. We see so much atrocities. We see countries, subhanAllah, that is praying over the countries that are left beneath them. And many are losing their lives. As Muslims, we must understand that we have an obligation to build communities. To build, we do not destroy, but rather we are builders. We take this from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We took this from the companions ridwanullah ta'ala alayhim. We are here and this is the type of understanding we need to instill in our youngsters. As we strive to build Masjid al-Abideen, we want to say to the youngsters that this is the work and this is the vision of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the companions to transform society through building and education, inshallah. When we talk about building, we're talking about building societies through education. Building society through tazkiyah, inshallah. My brothers and sisters, in the process of doing that, I say to you what will happen is that you will face many challenges in life. You will have challenges in life. All of you that is here, in one way or the other, you will go through problems. Whether it is in your homes, whether it is in your workplace, whether it is personal challenges that you go through. But understand that lesson. We continue to share with you the lesson from the eagle, that amazing animal. And we are told, subhanAllah, that the mother of that eagle, when she builds the nest, and you have the young eagle there in that nest, there are layers that to make that small eagle comfortable. Layers to make it comfortable. But after a period of time, what happens? That those layers are removed by the mothers. And there are thorns that are there. And the mother exposes the child or that eagle, that baby eagle, to the thorns in the nest so that they may understand that life is not easy. That you will face challenges. At times it will take the child and throw it out of the nest. This is a life lesson for all of us. That in life we will face hardship and tribulations. At this time in which we live in, my beloved brothers and sisters, Islam, this beautiful religion of ours, that it is hard to practice our religion because of our society being plagued across the globe with Islamophobia. And this should not be the reason for us to turn away from this religion. This is not the reason for our family members to turn away because of Islamophobia. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us that towards the ending of time, what will happen? Holding on to your religion would be like holding on to the hot coals. It will never be an easy path for you or your child. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Wallahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Walillahi alhamd. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, it is important at this time as well to understand as we try to practice our religion and as we strive inshallah to build a community based on taqwa inshallah, that we have to understand one of the greatest weapon that we have, that we have to use, is the weapon of love and compassion, as exemplified by our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In a society that is plagued with hate, subhanallah, the medicine for that hate is love. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us this. In a society that we see that is plagued with many atrocities, the weapon that we have to, subhanallah, use towards the racism that we have seen plaguing our society is the love that was taught to us by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As he tells us, subhanallah, tahabu, love, display love and compassion. Be an ambassador of love in this challenging time, and you will see your family transform and your society transform. My brothers and sisters, as I conclude this part of the khutbah, I want to share with you one practical example of how love can transform lives. How if we take that step of love, how we can transform lives and the society that we build, that we are striving to build. That it is not merely words that was practiced 1400 and odd years ago, and we said it's far away from us. This is not found in the presence of the Muslim community. In terms of love, our community is rich from it. No, there are many practical examples in our contemporary time that I share with you, inshallah. The story of, subhanallah, of a young boy at the age of 14 by the name of Sulaiman, subhanallah. As he was walking on the road, three persons came and jumped him and killed him, subhanallah. He lost his life, and this was dear in the media and so forth. And here is it, the mother, who is someone that accepted this religion of Islam, and the day of the court, she went and she embraced the person that killed her son and says, I cannot hate you. I cannot hate you. I cannot allow hate to fester. This is not our way. This is not our way in which the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught her and taught us. She embraced that child and embraced the mother of that person that took the life and says, I want to be a part of your life. I want to be a part of this child who, subhanallah, has killed her son. She says, I want to be a part of your transformation. And this display of forgiveness was taught to us by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It transformed the life of that young man. It transformed the life of that particular family because of simply displaying forgiveness and love, my beloved brothers and sisters. You can be an ambassador of love. You can be an ambassador of peace. You can be an ambassador of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Wallahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Walillahi alhamd.
Allahu fala mudilla lah. Wa man yudlil fala hadiya lah. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. Wa ashhadu anna sayyidina wa sadanana habibuna Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Wa lillahi alhamd.
My beloved brothers and sisters, as I conclude my khutbah, I ask our brothers and our sisters that is here to hug the brother beside you and tell them that you love them for the sake of Allah. We gather here because of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we are here, inshallah, in this joyous and festive time, and we share advice about the transformation of our society and the transformation of our life, let us, inshallah, use, inshallah, ourselves to be a beacon of light and a beacon of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So therefore, make that commitment and that covenant that you will always, inshallah, be that person that will show love in your actions and your words. That you will always be that individual that make that commitment, that looks out for the interests of those around you, that rather than your personal interest. Islam is all about serving Allah and serving humanity. So be that person. I invite all of you, inshallah, to be a part of Masjid al-Abideen.
be a part of our mission, be a part of the transformation of our society through education. Make that commitment today, inshallah, that Masjid al-Abidin will be your house, a place where you will come whenever you're going through hardship and troubles and tribulations in your life, that you could come here at Masjid al-Abidin, because here is a safe haven for you. Here is where you can find that comfort. Whenever you are having problems with your kids and hardship with them, know that Masjid al-Abidin is here to lend you a shoulder, to lean your head on, and to share your life challenges that you have. I want to mention to our brothers, inshallah, as you bid farewell to Ramadan, do not bid farewell to your servitude and the display of your servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us, this is a blessed day, and as such, I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us, guide us and protect us, and grant us goodness in this life and the life to come. May Allah separate us from our sins, like He has separated the east from the west, and may He cleanse us from our sins, like He has cleansed the white cloth and filth. May Allah shade us under His majestic throne, the day there will be no shade and shelter except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah forgive our mothers and our fathers, our brothers and our sisters who have wronged in any way. May Allah look upon them with the eyes of mercy and admit them all in paradise. May Allah bless our community and the children in our community, inshallah. May Allah remove the obstacle from their way, and may Allah pave the way for them and grant them a tawfiq, inshallah. بارك الله لكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعنا وإياكم بذكر حكيم إنه تعالى جواد كريم ورعوف رحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون.
لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده. لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يا رب لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك ولعظيم سلطانك. اللهم لك الحمد حمدا كثيرا طيبا مطيبا مباركا فيك كما تحب ربنا وترضى. ملء السماء وملء الأرض وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شئت من شيء بعد. أهل الثناء والعظمة والمجد أحق ما قال العبد وكلنا لك عبد. ربنا لك الحمد على نعمة الإسلام ولك الحمد على نعمة الإيمان ولك الحمد على نعمة القرآن ولك الحمد على نعمة السفر والمال والأهل والولدان. ربنا لك الحمد أن خلقتنا ولك الحمد أن رزقتنا ولك الحمد أن سترتنا ولك الحمد أن آويتنا ولك الحمد بما فرجت عنا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وفي الآخرين وفي الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وقنا واصرف عنا برحمتك شر ما قضيت. اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا وتقبل منا قيامنا وتقبل منا قيامنا وتقبل منا قيامنا وتقبل قراءتنا للقرآن وتقبل قراءتنا للقرآن وتقبل قراءتنا للقرآن. اللهم إن كنا قد أسأنا أو تجاوزنا أو قصرنا فاعف عنا فإنك عفو كريم. اللهم إن كنا قد أسأنا أو تجاوزنا أو قصرنا
فاعف عنا فإنك عفو كريم. اللهم إن كنا قد أسأنا أو تجاوزنا أو قصرنا فاعف عنا فإنك عفو كريم. ربنا اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت على الحق أقدامنا واهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. ربنا آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. ربنا تب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم واغفر لنا إنك أنت الجواد الكريم. ربنا طهر قلوبنا وزك نفوسنا واستر عيوبنا وارفع درجاتنا وتجاوز عن سيئاتنا. واغفر يا رب لآبائنا وأمهاتنا وزوجاتنا وأولادنا وإخواننا ومشايخنا وعلمائنا وأصحاب الحقوق علينا. اللهم اغفر للأحياء منا والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. اللهم وأتمم بناء مسجد العابدين، اللهم أتمم بناء مسجد العابدين، اللهم يسر بناءه، اللهم يسر بناءه وأتممه على خير وجه يا أكرم الأكرمين. ربنا وفق القائمين على أمره وارزقهم السداد والرشاد وارزقهم الإخلاص في القول والعمل، واجعلنا وإياهم وسائر الحاضرين من أهلك وخاصتك يا أكرم الأكرمين. ربنا ألف بين قلوبنا وأصلح ذات بيننا ولا تجعل في نفوسنا حقدا للذين آمنوا. ربنا انزع الغل والحقد والحسد والبغضاء من قلوبنا. اللهم وحد صف المسلمين في كل مكان، اللهم اجمع شمل المسلمين في كل مكان، اللهم ارفع راية المسلمين في كل مكان. ربنا هيئ لهذه الأمة أمر رشد يعز فيه أهل الطاعات ويهدى فيه أهل المعاصي. ربنا ارفع راية الإسلام عالية خفاقة على العالمين. ربنا وحرر الأقصى الشريف ورده علينا سالما غانما معافى وارزقنا فيه صلاة قبل الممات. اللهم واحفظ سائر مقدسات المسلمين. ربنا اهد أولادنا وأعنا على تربيتهم وتأديبهم والإحسان إليهم واجعلنا لهم قدوة صالحة. اللهم احفظ شباب المسلمين واحفظ بنات المسلمين. اللهم نشئهم على القرآن والإيمان واجعلهم يا رب محفوظين بحفظك وكلأهم بعينك وباعد بينهم وبين مردة الإنس والجن برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم وبلغنا رمضان، اللهم بلغنا رمضان، اللهم بلغنا رمضان، اللهم بلغنا رمضان، اللهم بلغنا رمضان. اللهم اكتب لنا يا رب حجا وعمرة كل عام واجعلنا من المقبولين. ربنا سلمتنا رمضان فسلمه منا يا رب سالما نقيا واجعله في ميزان حسناتنا. تسلمه منا على الوجه الذي يرضيه، تسلمه منا وتجاوز عن تقصيرنا فيه، تسلمه منا وارزقنا خيره وبره واجعله شاهدا لنا بين يديك يوم القيامة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه، لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه، لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا. لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده. لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين بسر القرآن وبسر الفاتحة. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My beloved brothers and sisters, we thank Sheikh Fahmi and our beloved Qari and Sheikh Ibrahim while for spending this Ramadan with us. Meet them here as we go home and meet our family and children. They are here and they are away from their family and children. So let them feel the hospitality of Majid al-Abidin. Come and embrace them and come and give them salam.
I hope you enjoy the football.
We extend sincere thanks to all of you. To all of the hardworking members of our community, our brothers who stood the kitchen and fed us all months. Alhamdulillah, over 30,000 meals were served at Majid al-Abidin this year. Jazakumullah khair for all your hard work. And of course, we thank Imam Zamir Sattar and his family, night after night, going out, not forgetting Sarah and Musa and the daughter of Brother Hayat, all of them going out and being at the forefront of the revealing of Majid al-Abidin. We reward all of them generously, inshallah. Please come and meet some of our Shaykh and give them salams and extend your greetings. Inshallah, as we settle down a little bit after, we will need some assistance to pull back the rugs and to put them back into the masjid, inshallah. So Jazakumullah khair, we will kindly assist as soon as all the festivities come down a bit. And there is a clipboard going around to get your contact details. Please make sure that you put the details on it and send the clipboard back up. Just back over
there. All right.
We need some assistance to roll up the carpet, please. Or else everything will be left on the street. Please, we need your help. Ramadan Mubarak, brother. Ramadan Mubarak. Eid Saeed to each and every one of you. Eid greetings to all of you. May Allah bless each and every one of you.
Alian.
Walaikum salam.
Alian.
Please, we need some help to roll up the carpets and to get it back into the masjid compound, because we have to clear the streets. Please, brothers and sisters, brothers, and when you are specially invited to go by Bakewell restaurant next door on Liberty Avenue, and you'll be treated, compliments of Bakewell. There's some pastries and tea or coffee, I don't know which one, but just check it for you, please. Compliments of Mr. Chief Sanchir of Bakewell. And doctor, that's not the only sponsor. We must also pay a lot of respect to Brother Hafiz Ali of Rockaway Roti Shop, who has donated a lot of meals to Masjid and who has helped out along with our brothers. So I want to say a special thank you. Rahman's Halal, I want to say a special thank you to Rahman's Halal, butchery right in the corner, and several other brothers and businesses that have donated during the month of Ramadan towards the Masjid. Let
me, on behalf of the Imam and executives of Masjid Al-Abidin, extend sincere thanks and gratitude to all the sponsors, all the donors, and everyone who has today and all the other days make a contribution towards the Masjid Fund. And all the prospective donors, the would-be donors, and those who has a near to the intention to donate towards Al-Abidin Masjid, we want to thank you and make dua for you. May Allah bless each and every one of you. And at this time, let me take the opportunity on behalf of the former Jubilees, Radio Programs and Promotions, to wish each and every one of you a joyous, happy, and prosperous Eid-ul-Fitr, and also in the next year to come, all success.
Special greetings and deep greetings going on to Curry Fish and Restaurant, Mr. Alan and his school. Curry Fish and Restaurant, Mr. Alan and his staff. Not forgetting Darbar Restaurant, special thanks to all the businesses in the school that actually have to the hard-working staff and the executives of Masjid Al-Abidin, on behalf of the Imam and the executive, I want to say a special thank you. Special thank you to Imam Zamir Sattar and his entire family and crew. May Allah bless each and every one of you. And Mr. Firoz Sattar, who has been the minibus for... We would like to say a special thank you to Firoz Sattar and everybody else. Coffee break. We have some Bobby in front. You can speak to your sandwiches. Bobby and refreshment in front. By Liberty and one for design. And you're also treated at this moment to get in front of Bakewell Restaurant for some pastries and the just get in front of Bakewell where you'll be treated with
now after Masjid, this is what you go to do.
No, that's what
you go to do. Eat your food.
You come around, meet family, and enjoy
some nice food. YouTube!
Eid-ul-Fitr! YouTube!